ask ladies cover their head. Brothers, uncover their head. We're going to stand and face Jerusalem and open up.
Our Father, which art in heaven.
Our Father, which art in heaven.
Hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done in earth.
Thy will be done in earth.
As it is in heaven.
As it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our debts.
And forgive us our debts.
As we forgive our debtors.
As we forgive our debtors.
Lead us not into temptation.
And lead us not into temptation.
But deliver us from evil.
But deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom.
For thine is the kingdom.
And the power.
And the power.
And the glory forever.
And the glory forever.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
For he is good.
For he is good.
For his mercy endureth forever.
For his mercy endureth forever.
Praise the Lord God of Israel.
Praise the Lord God of Israel.
For he is good.
For he is good.
For his mercy endureth forever.
For his mercy endureth forever. In Jesus' name we pray.
The Lamb of God.
The Lamb of God.
The King of Kings.
The King of Kings.
Amen.
Amen.
Today's scripture reading is from 1 Thessalonians 4th chapter, verses 15 through 18.
For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore comfort one another with these words. Today's scripture reading was from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 15 through 18. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and doing of his word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Now a couple selections from the Israel Church of Jesus choir.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
When you see me walking right,
when you see me walking right,
when you hear me talking right,
when you hear me talking right,
when you see me living right,
when you see me living right,
and when you see me giving right,
when you see me giving right,
don't worry,
oh, 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 oh.
He's using my hands
to do his blessed will.
He's using my feet.
He's using my feet to climb the rugged hill.
He's using my arms.
He's using my eyes that I may see
some good in others.
Some good in others to save as me.
He's using my voice.
He's using my voice. Give sight to the blind.
And he's using me.
He's using me in his own good time.
So don't worry.
Oh. Oh, 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 God is using me. Jesus is using me.
When you see me do my best,
when you see me do my best,
and when you see me stand the test,
when you see me stand the test,
and when I suffer all night long,
when I suffer all night long,
or I'm lifting up my voice in song,
lifting up my voice in song,
don't worry,
oh, 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 God is using me, Jesus is using me,
he's using my hands,
he's using my hands,
he's using my feet.
He's using my feet to climb that rugged hill.
He's using my eyes.
He's using my eyes that I may see
some good in others.
Some good in others the same as me.
He's using my voice.
He's using my voice. Gives sight to the blind.
And he's using me.
He's using me in his own good time.
So don't worry.
Oh, 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 oh. God is using me, Jesus is using me.
my hands.
He's using my hands to do his blessed will.
He's using my feet.
He's using my feet to climb the rugged hill.
He's using my eyes.
He's using my eyes that I may see
some good in others.
Some good in others the same as me.
Oh, he's using my voice.
He's using my voice to get side to the
land. He's using me.
He's using me. Time.
So don't worry.
Oh, 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 oh. God is using me. Jesus is using me.
So don't worry.
Oh, 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 oh. God is using me. Jesus is using me.
So don't worry.
Oh, 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 oh.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
How y'all feeling out there today?
Good.
Y'all feeling lovely?
Oh,
it is the Sabbath, man. I feel lovely today myself. You know what I mean? I don't know about y'all, but I'm happy in the Lord. You know what I mean? We get to do what the whole world, most of the world, really ain't doing. They ain't doing the commandments of God. God commanded us to rest today.
Yes,
come into his house with praise and thanksgiving. Ain't we supposed to? Because you know what he brought us from, right?
Amen.
Dealing with people, dealing with these folly days, dealing with the stuff that's going on. You know what I mean? Nobody know our pain and our struggle, but our Father do. You know what I mean? Our Lord does.
Amen.
So, you know, when we come into his house, we're going to be happy.
Amen.
We're going to sing some praises to the Father. Go ahead, Keith. All right. Just a little taste of value. Just a little taste. There we go. Good. All right. If y'all feeling this a little bit, I want y'all to go ahead and clap y'all hands. Y'all hear? All right. Here we go.
Take me in your arms and hold me close. Let me hear y'all. Let me hear you say melodies.
Melodies from heaven.
Come on, one more time, y'all. Come on, let me hear you say. Let me hear you say melodies.
Melodies from heaven.
Mm-hmm. Come on, y'all.
Send it down, Lord.
Amen, amen. Another round of applause for the choir. We try up here, singing praise to the Most High God. I love y'all. All right, praise the Most High God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and peace to everybody here. In Jesus' name,
peace.
All right, we're here doing what thus saith the Lord, another Sabbath day. It's a beautiful day, and what the Lord put on my heart to bring to the congregation, I feel is very much needed, very much needed. You know, brothers and sisters, I believe, tend to forget how serious and how important it is to stay in this life and to stay pressing towards that mark, because we want to do what the Lord has commanded us to do. Very important. I think that some of us then forgot, since we got in that water, how we're supposed to be walking. We're supposed to ever be mindful that we didn't get this. The Lord didn't shed his light on us to come out of darkness just for us to be walking around willy-nilly, thinking that we're going to creep our way into the kingdom without no type of works or without no type of struggle that's going on here. See, those that's going to get to the kingdom is truly going to be worthy to get there.
That's right.
Truly. With so great a gift that the Lord is going to give to us by becoming God, he's just not going to give that to anybody. You understand?
Right.
He's not going to give it to anybody. The title that I have right here in my most earnest Jamaican voice: everybody want heaven, but nobody want dead. Now, we all know that we ain't going to the pie in the sky. That great pie in the sky, right?
That's
as
right.
People say. We know what time it is. We know that heaven won't be right here on earth, right?
That's right.
Okay. And as a matter of fact, you got some real understanding. You know that the earth is heaven? You already know that heaven is earth.
Right?
Because it's three heavens, right?
That's right.
Most people don't even have that understanding.
Don't even.
But it's okay. But now we're going to read that we have a great example in our brother, our Lord, our Savior, on how you are supposed to die. You got to die to yourself. Die to those things that you held on so dearly before you got into that water. Because all of us being here know that before we got in that water, we had to bring what? Fruits meet for repentance. That means you had to do your studying. You had to do your getting into this word and understanding that there's something that I have to do when I come underneath this water. When I come underneath this water, the Lord's going to take away my sins, my past sins, right?
Right.
And then I'm going to walk in newness of life, right?
Right.
So that means you can't do the things that you was doing before you came into this knowledge. You're supposed to love your brother and sister, right?
That's right.
You're supposed to love God above all.
That's right.
Don't carry no malice in your heart, right, brothers and sisters? If you, before, when you was in the world, you might have a problem or ought with your brother and sister, and what would you do? You know, you might talk to another brother and be like, man, forget that person, man, or another sister. You know what? She does this, that, third, this, that. But, you know, when you come into the Word of God, you're supposed to do what? You're supposed to go and talk to your brother and sister if you have a problem with them, right?
Yes, sir.
You ain't supposed to do like you did back in the world, where you could talk about somebody and, you know, wish ill will on them. You're supposed to do unto others as you would have them do unto you.
Teach.
But people do not, y'all think it's a game. Y'all think it's a game out here. You think that you're going to skip your way into the kingdom without putting into practice what is in this word. God said, sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth.
That's right.
The very way that you brothers and sisters treat each other demonstrates how much you are in your word. It demonstrates. See, you don't have to put the mask on in front of people that's really dealing with the word of God. Because God has a discerning spirit. He put a discerning spirit on you. Hey, brother, hey, sister, you know what? I've been reading my word of God, and I've been doing this. 5 minutes later, go outside. You know what? Forget that nigga over there. Forget that chick over there. Or talking real bad. And you said you've been reading the word of God? The way you act, brothers and sisters, demonstrate how much you've been praying to the Most High God. Your time in prayer with the Lord is displayed on how you treat your brothers and sisters out here. And don't think that it's not known. God sees everything, brothers and sisters. He sees everything. And he'll bring it across, brothers and sisters like myself, Brother Brandon, Brother Elijah, and check it, and we'll have to address it. What are we up here for? What are the brothers and sisters that stand up here in this pulpit for? To teach, right? We must speak the truth. God is no respecter of persons. We all too often do exactly what Matthew 7 instructs us not to do. Verse 1. Judge not, lest ye be judged. Turn there real fast before we get into the lesson. Mm-hmm. Turn it real fast before we get into the lesson. Brother, when you get to verse 1, start reading, brother. Matthew chapter 7, it's not on the handout. Verse 1.
Judge not that ye be not judged.
Go ahead.
For with what judgment ye judge, ye shall be judged.
Mm-hmm.
And with what measure ye meet, it shall be measured to you again.
Mm-hmm.
And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but considerest not the beam that is in thine own eye?
All too often, we quick to see what's going on with our brother and our sister, and don't care to check ourselves. We don't care to check ourselves, do we, brothers and sisters? Nah, we don't care. Judge not that ye be not judged, for with what judgment ye judge, ye shall be judged. And with what measure ye meet, it shall be measured to you again. You want to talk to your brother and sister filthy? You want to talk down on your brother and sister? Okay, don't worry. It's going to come back to you. It'll come right back to you. God is no respecter of persons, brothers and sisters. And he's not mocked, brothers and sisters. If you're going to reap what you sow. He who wants to be friendly, wants friends, must show himself what?
Friendly.
Right? How you going to be friendly? You call yourself friendly, but you won't even invite nobody over to your house. You friendly. You friendly? You won't even give nobody a ride home or bring them, pick them up and bring them to church. Oh, no, brother and sister, that's too far out my way. No, I ain't going there. I can't, you know what? There's a lot of hypocritical stuff that we do in here. Everybody want heaven, but nobody want dead. Everybody want the glory, but nobody want to do what's necessary in order to get the glory. And although we Israel, we the chosen people, you get puffed up in yourself. You do. I know you do. You can't even talk sensibly to your brothers and sisters around here. We're going to get into it, though, because we got our master, our savior, our Lord, and our brother that's going to be show us the perfect example on how we're supposed to act with one another. We're going to get right into it. Matthew. I'm sorry. Verse 4, brother, read verse 4.
Or how wilt thou say to thy brother?
Sorry, did you read verse 3? Because I'm getting ahead of myself.
Yeah,
I'm too excited.
I read three.
You read three? Read three over again, brother.
And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but considerest not the beam that is in thine own eye?
So he says, could you want to look at the mote? You want to look at the mote that's in your brother's eye, but won't consider that beam that's sticking out your eye. Shouldn't do these things, brother and sister. But we got the, our master's going to show us how to do this. And I hope that you take notes. See, when you come here, I'm really realizing. When you come here, this is a show of, hey, what you do all week. Hey, did you see that game? Hey, did you see this, that, and the third? No, you're here to learn how to get salvation, period. That's it. We're here to learn how to become God. That's it. If we decide to say anything, your words better be about the Lord. You have 6 days that we're compiled around people that don't care nothing about God. You should be happy when you come into the house of the Lord that you got people that are like-minded like you, and you should be overjoyed and flabbergasted. The choir doesn't need to pump you up. You should already be pumped up when you come here. You've been around idolaters, liars, thieves, adulterers, sodomites, all around there, and you got to keep your integrity in front of these people. You're mocked at, you're scorned in front of these people. And when you come around the people of God, you too cute. Give the Lord praise for bringing you through this day, bringing you to the day that He commanded you to do. He got your life in his hands. Your very breath is in His hands. And you don't take time to study. You don't take time to pray. You don't take time to teach your children. I understand you work 40 hours a week. I understand this. You work 40 hours, 40 plus sometimes. Deuteronomy chapter 6 tells you that you're supposed to teach your child when he get up, when he's sitting at the table, when he walks by the way, when he lay down. Your job doesn't stop, brothers and sisters. I'm going into this because the Lord put this on my heart and my mind. And I must say what thus say the Lord. See, if I don't say what thus say the Lord, who's going to get judged here? I love y'all. Y'all opinion to me when it comes to the Lord doesn't matter. So I don't fear y'all. I fear the Lord. I'm going to say what He says. Did you finish that, brother?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Verse 4. Or how wilt thou say to thy brother, let me pull out the mote out of thine eye, and behold, a beam is in thine own eye.
What the Lord tell you to do, man?
Thou hypocrite.
What do he call you?
Hypocrite.
Say that nice and loud, man.
Hypocrite.
Go ahead.
First cast out the beam out of thine own eye, and then shalt thou see clearly to cast out the mote out of thy brother's eye.
Far too often we don't do this, brothers and sisters. Far too more often we have an opinion about something and we haven't even worked on ourselves so that we can be clear on and concise on what we have opinion about. We're going to get into this. We're going to start at Matthew chapter 20. Everybody wants heaven, nobody wants dead. Everybody wants that glory, but you don't want to do what you're supposed to do in order to get it. We're going to start at Matthew chapter 20. Verse 17. And when you get there, brother, go ahead and start. Matthew chapter 20, verse 17. Brother, when you get there, go ahead.
And Jesus, going up to Jerusalem, took the 12 disciples apart in the way and said unto them,
what'd he say?
Behold, we go up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man shall be betrayed unto the chief priest and unto the scribes, and they shall condemn him to death.
What I want you to understand is that Jesus knew when he was going to die. We don't. Our time is always. But you should often catch yourself and wonder, you know what? What would you do if you knew the exact moment and date when you would die? What would you do? That's just something for you to think about. If you knew exactly how you was going to die, what was going to happen, what would you do and how would you conduct your life? Our brother, our Lord, and our Savior, he knew exactly when he was going to die, and he's telling his closest people to him, the disciples, that some didn't even believe. They didn't understand. They didn't understand, rather, what he was talking about. Read that over again, brother.
And Jesus, going up to Jerusalem, took the 12 disciples apart in the way, and said unto them, Behold, we go up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man shall be betrayed unto the chief priest and unto the scribes, and they shall condemn him to death, and shall deliver him to the Gentiles to mock, and to scourge, and to crucify him, and the third day he shall rise again.
Okay, so he's telling them, he's letting them know what's going to happen to him. And let's see, right after he tells them this, what the mother of the two disciples is going to ask him. Go ahead.
Then came to him the mother of Zebedee's children with her sons worshiping him and desiring a certain thing of him. And he said unto her, What wilt thou? And she saith unto him, Grant that these my two sons may sit, the one on thy right hand and the other on the left, in thy kingdom. But Jesus answered and said, Ye know not what ye ask.
You know what you ask? You don't even know what you're asking. Go ahead.
Are ye able to drink of the cup that I shall drink of? And to be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with. They said unto him, We are able.
We quick to say that. Hey, listen, y'all said it when y'all got in the water. Lord, we're going to do everything that you said for us to do. We're going to do it. Okay. You're going to treat your brother and your sister like as you would treat yourself. You're going to keep these commandments, right? You're going to put God first. You know what? If I have an ought with my brother and I have an ought with my sister, you know what? Instead of me talking about them, I'm going to go and bring my issue to them. Are you going to put away them grudges that you have? Are you going to love one another? Okay, it's quick. You want to do that? Let's see. Come on. Keep 23. Reading, brother.
And he saith unto them, Ye shall drink indeed of my cup.
Ye shall drink indeed. Come on.
And be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with. But to sit on my right hand and on my left is not mine to give, but it shall be given to them for whom it is prepared of my Father.
Because this was going to happen. Anybody that called himself Christ, you're going to drink of that cup. You know what that cup is? You're going to get persecuted. You're going to get laughed at. You're going to get scorned. You're going to get mocked. You're going to have to leave your family members and everybody. You're going to have to get and be by yourself. It's going to happen to you. You're going to drink of this cup. Because unless you do, you ain't going to have no part of Christ. Because you got to be purged. You got to be tried like gold in the fire to see if you are worthy. Matter of fact, are your words, you said you do it, by your very words, you're either going to be condemned or you're going to be justified by your very words. The Bible's written in this book. Keep going, brother.
24. And when the 10 heard it, they were moved with indignation against the two brethren.
Like, man, who are these? Come on, man. You want to sit down and be closer to the Father? Because they was already arguing, bickering about who's the greatest in the kingdom. thinking about carnal things. Who's the greatest in the kingdom? Who's the greatest in the kingdom? Christ brought a child to him and said, what? Unless you become like this child, you should not enter into the kingdom, right? Why? What does a child do? A child's impressionable. You can tell a child what's going on. They're humble. They're not hardened in their hardest, foolish heart, thinking that they are right all the time. They're impressionable. 23 says, and he said unto them, ye shall drink indeed of my cup and be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with. But to sit on my right hand and on my left, it is not mine to give, but it shall be given to them whom is prepared of my Father. Read verse 25, brother.
But Jesus called unto him and said, ye know that the princes of the Gentiles exercise dominion over them, and they that are great exercise authority upon them.
This is what the Gentiles do. Go on.
But it shall not be so among you.
It shall not be so among us, brothers and sisters. How's it supposed to be?
But whosoever will be great among you, let him be your minister.
Do y'all know how to do that? What's a minister?
Servant.
Let's see. Y'all should be well informed. A minister is what? A servant, right? Whoever's going to be great among you, you're supposed to be a servant. Keep going, brother.
And whosoever will be chief among you, let him be your servant.
Hello. In the world full of self-promoting, you know, prideful people, to tell somebody like this, they got a phrase in the world says what? The nice guy finished last, right? This is what we're surrounded by in this world. So when you call yourself being a servant to somebody and always taking the lower role, you looked upon as you soft. You weak. He's a pushover. She's a pushover. When the very word is telling you the greatest among you is going to be a servant. Because guess what? It takes more strength to be humble than to be prideful.
True indeed.
When you know that you're stronger than somebody or may have a little bit more knowledge than somebody, and that pride want to jump up in you and you want to be able to talk to somebody and say what's on your mind, it takes more strength to be humble. Not even just mean be quiet. Let me esteem this brother or sister a little bit more than myself. I know he or she may be talking a little bit out of the way or whatever, but you know what? Let me at least hear what they got to say, and then let me administer my knowledge in love and in humility. Because nobody wants to hear a know-it-all and pridefulness. They don't want to hear that. You may just win that soul, and you may be right with what he's saying, but guess what? If you know, if you always bucking up, never let nobody speak, say anything before they can get out any word, you done lost that person. You know, I go to somebody out in the street and listen to him. They may be wrong, but at least he listened to me. You have to become all things to all peoples, brothers and sisters. You have to learn how to walk this walk, and it's not an easy walk, brothers and sisters. This is what we're getting at here. The 25 says, but Jesus called them unto him and said, ye know that the princes of the Gentiles exercise dominion over them. You got bosses at your job. You got people, you got police officers, you got judges, you got everybody that's all over top of you all the time because they exercise authority. This is the world we live in. And they that are great exercise authority upon them. But it shall not be so among you. But whosoever will be great among you, let him be your minister. And whosoever will be chief among you, let him be your servant. Go ahead, brother.
Even as the Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister and to give his life a ransom for many.
Jesus is God that became man. Full of, when he rose up, Matthew 28, he said, well, all power is given into my hand, right? That's the glory he had before he was man. He had all power. But he humbled himself and put on this man, this flesh, and die for who? Hey, listen, rub your arm, no, put a little spit on it, rub it, and then get that little dirt that come up. That's all you are. You dirt. When you want to think that you something, you're dirt.
That's right.
True.
You're dirt. So what makes you put your pants on the same way I do? Use the bathroom, some of y'all, the same way I do. You're dirt. So where does this pride come in at? Where does it come in at? What makes you think you something? Read, brother. Oh, I'm sorry. We're gonna go a little further. We're gonna go a little bit further. Turn to Revelations. The Son of Man didn't come to get ministered to be ministered unto, but he to minister and to give his life a ransom for many. Revelations chapter 3. He's our example, brothers and sisters. Everybody want heaven. Nobody want that. You willing to give your life for somebody? You really give your life for me? No. I like your honesty, sis. Love your honesty. Yeah. We're going to read that. Are y'all willing to, for the betterment of your brother, take the humble role? Are y'all willing to be smacked in y'all face in order to gain somebody? Lord, come right now. How many people really worthy you think to stand before your maker? How much time do y'all take in y'all 6 days? God said he give you 6 days, do what you want to do or whatever. You know, do your own will. Do what you want to do. You know what I mean? But y'all just wait until the Sabbath to pick your Bible up and start reading. How many of y'all get on y'all knees and ask for your brother and sister to be helped during the week that God give you anything to do? How many of y'all think about, you know what, let me pray for this nation, or let me pray for this in this 6 days that God give you to do whatever you want to do? How much time do you take with your Savior? How much time? It shows on how you treat your brother and sister. See, you can't fool God. Anytime any situation comes up in your life that you think you can't deal with, do you call your brother and sister first, or do you seek God's face first? A situation that come up in your life, you know, you ain't gotta ask me. This is all for you, brothers and sisters. You can lie to me, but you can't lie to God. Is God always on your right hand, or are you relying on man all the time to help you? How much time? Everybody want heaven, but nobody want dead. Y'all open up y'all door to strangers? Y'all clothe the needy? Feed the homeless? Do you go visit people you visit sick people? The sick and shut in, do y'all go and visit? Do you take time out of your busy schedule to go and help somebody else that's less fortunate to you? Let me show y'all something. Pause. Go to Acts chapter 2 real fast. Go to Acts chapter 2. Because we need to get it together, brothers. So the time is winding up. And we think it's a game out here. You really think this is a game? We're going to get right to it. Acts chapter 2, verse 44. We're going to get right to it. Let's see. They say that this is when the church started, but we know the church started in the wilderness way back. But let's see what happened after Pentecost. We're going to get right to it. Read verse 44.
And all that believed were together and had all things common.
They had all things common. The rich, the poor. What they do? Keep reading.
And sold their possessions and goods.
What they do?
Sold their possessions and goods.
Come on.
And parted them to all men, as every man had need. And they, continuing daily with one accord in the temple, and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart.
Now, I know some of y'all got $50,000 in bank accounts. I know y'all got $10,000. Hey, I know y'all got big homes. I know y'all got a lot of property. How much of that property y'all ready to give up and give to the homeless? How much of your bank account are you ready to throw to the side and give to somebody helping them follow the Lord? What they say here? All that the believed came were together.
And all that believed were together and had all things common.
They had all things common. Some of y'all have more than others. Some have little, but we had all things in common. All had one mind. They were straight, set on the kingdom. A lot of division up in here. Go ahead, keep reading.
And sold their possessions and goods and parted them to all men as every man had need.
What did Jesus say? What did Jesus say to the rich? He wasn't his disciple, but the rich young ruler that came to him and asked him, what must I do in order to make it into the kingdom? What did he tell him? Keep the commandments, right?
Yes, sir.
This I did all for my youth, right? But if you want to be perfect, what are you supposed to do?
Sell all the devil.
You want to be perfect? How many of y'all want to be perfect? I hear you. I hear you. If you can't get on your knee, you know, if you don't spend no time with the Father during the week, how can you possibly think you're going to make it in the kingdom? Yeah, he has stipulations, you know what I mean? This is just, if you want to do the bare minimum, you want to get the bare minimum reward, aren't you? You gonna get the bare minimum. Yeah, well, you said I could do whatever I want for the 6 days. The seventh day I came here, and then you can't even do that right. Come here on the seventh day, you talk about whatever you want to talk about. You don't sing, you don't want to dance, you don't want to clap your hands. Lord, have mercy. You get what you get. Y'all ready? Y'all ready for the kingdom, right? Verse 46 says what, brother?
And they, continuing daily with one accord in the temple and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all people. And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved.
All right. Just wanted to get off on a tangent right there. Isaiah, I let the Spirit use me. We're going to get back on course. Revelations. This is how we're supposed to be, brothers and sisters. Revelation chapter 3. Verse 1, we're going to get into it. It's the Sabbath day. We're not going anywhere. And we're supposed to get into this word. Revelation chapter 3, verse 1 to 3. We're going to read a couple places here. We have in our Savior, we have an example how we're supposed to be. The greatest among us is going to be our servant. So let's go.
And unto the angel of the church in Sardis write.
What do you say?
These things saith he that hath the seven spirits of God and the seven stars.
Go ahead.
I know thy works, that thou hast a name, that thou livest and art dead.
Thou hast a name. Yeah, you got Israel, right? Y'all Israel? Y'all Israel? Yes. Y'all got a name that you live, right? Yes. You got a name that you live, but what'd he say?
And are dead.
Keep on going.
Be watchful and strengthen the things which remain that are ready to die.
What may be ready to die? You know what? My love may be ready to die. My tolerance for people, my tolerance for my brother and sister, that may be ready to die. Now I just might be cold all the way around the board. Strengthen that which remain and that may be ready to die. What? Go ahead.
For I have not found thy works perfect before God.
Come on.
Remember therefore how thou hast received and heard, and hold fast and repent. If therefore thou shalt not watch, I will come on thee as a thief, and thou shalt not know what hour I will come upon thee.
Careful. If y'all won't watch. Remember therefore how thou hast received and heard. You have received and heard this word, right? You had to receive it and hear it. That's why you got into the water and got baptized. Remember that. Remember what you're doing this for. Remember what this is. Because y'all should constantly be trying to better yourselves. Constantly. examine yourself every day. You should, this ain't no comfortable walk. If you're comfortable serving the Lord, it's a problem. It's a real life problem. Hold fast and repent. If therefore thou shalt not watch, I will come on thee as a thief, and thou shalt not know what hour I will come. Do y'all want that? A lot of people might, man, be resting, man. Rest in the Lord. Take you up out of here. Oh, you know what? Lord, forgive me. Forgive me. I know I was wrong. Father, forgive me. Forgive me. I didn't mean to do this. Some people don't got that chance. Some people get that stumbling block. Lord, put a stumbling block in and take you. You're going to have to answer for that sin. Don't think you can wait till the Day of Atonement next year to not do anything. You might not have it. Check yourself. And I hope y'all paying attention to what I'm talking about up here. I hope y'all are. I hope you're taking notes. Where are we at, brother?
19.
Read it.
As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten.
Okay.
Be zealous, therefore, and repent. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him and will sup with him and he with me.
How's he going to sup with you, brothers and sisters? Through his word. Through his word. That I hope y'all reading during the week. So you can clean your mind up. Clean your thoughts up. Clean your actions. That would exalt itself against God. Where else are we at, brother?
21.
Go ahead.
To him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne.
Oh! We just read that, didn't we?
No.
Didn't we read that in Matthew?
Yeah, sir.
We read that in Matthew, right?
I hear you, Art.
What we read in Matthew? It's not the Lord to give, is it?
Mm-hmm.
But to whom his Father has prepared it for, that sitting in his throne, right?
Yes, sir.
Hopefully he's prepared for y'all. Not all Israel's Israel. Keep reading, brother. Skip to verse 5. Go back to verse 5.
He that overcometh, the same shall be clothed in white raiment.
Go ahead.
And I will not blot out his name out of the book of life.
We don't want that.
But I will confess his name before my Father and before his angels.
Matthew chapter 10, if you don't confess the Father, if you're ashamed to confess him before people, he's going to be ashamed to confess you.
Right.
Before his Father. And we need that. Let's move a little further. Go to Colossians. Because we're going to work on us today. Amen. We're going to work on us, man. Because we need this. We need this. Colossians. Colossians chapter 3. And when we get there, brother, start at verse 1.
If ye then be risen with Christ,
uh-huh,
seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth.
This is what we need to set our affections on. When Christ was here, what did he do? He prayed to the Father. You know what I mean? He always heard him. He did what he helped the sick. He healed the sick. He helped the lame, you know? He did a whole bunch of things. You know, he was of a meek spirit. He's our example. Keep going.
For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God.
Go ahead.
When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory.
He said, when Christ, who is our life, right?
Yes, sir.
Christ is your life. Not football, not basketball, not PlayStation. Because people don't want to give these things up. People don't know how to actually live moderately. I'll be in one of them. I sit up all night and play the PlayStation or look at a movie. And then as soon as I get ready to read the Bible, I'm sleeping. Shame, man. That's a shame. I go to the club all night, play pool, drink, have it up. Have it. When it's time to pray, our Father with our. Y'all, you're laughing, but it's not a game. It is not a game. And I'm harping on this thing because you got to understand this. We only have a little bit of time here. Me. Up here, we say this a couple hours, 2 hours, and then we go away. Boom. Boom. Till next week. Got a whole week. What have you learned? What have you learned? Do you even go home and pick up other lessons and then go over them? See, ask the Lord to open up your mind and your understanding that you're going to see, that you can see his wonders in his word. I'm being for real up here because I wasn't doing it. You call yourself a teacher, you call yourself a minister, you call yourself, you know, just because you're sitting out in the congregation, you think you ain't got no responsibility? The Lord, I'm going to read. Don't worry, I got something for y'all. Where we at, brother?
Verse 5. Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth.
Mortify them. What does mortify mean?
Kill.
Kill the members. Mortify therefore the members which are upon the earth. Go ahead. He's going to read off some of them. Come on.
Fornication.
I know some of y'all ain't married out there. In the sense that we supposed to be. Kill that fornication. Go ahead.
Uncleanness.
Go ahead.
Inordinate affection.
Inordinate affections. That's passions. Go ahead.
Evil concupiscence and covetousness.
That's desires. Evil desires and what?
Covetousness.
Keep going.
Which is idolatry.
Which is idolatry. 10th commandment. Come on.
For which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience.
Keep them going.
In the which ye also walked some time.
Didn't you? Didn't we?
Yes, sir.
Come on.
When ye lived in them.
Go ahead.
But now ye also put off all these.
Put off all these what?
Anger.
Come on.
Wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth.
The Lord's telling you, but you, it's not a problem with you getting angry. God get angry. And we made of the same substance as him. So, you know, we laugh, we cry, we joke, you know what I mean? But listen, when you're supposed to be angry, but you ain't supposed to do what? Sin. Come on, I know y'all read. Be angry with what? Sin not. Because things get on my nerves. So I know it get on yours. Go ahead. Where you at, brother?
7. In the which ye also walked some time when ye lived in them. I don't read that. But,
go ahead. It's all
but
right.
Now ye also put off all these.
Go ahead.
Anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds.
So this is what the old man should do before he got in that water, right? Put it off. Go ahead. Keep reading, brother.
And have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. Skip to 12.
No, read 10.
All right.
Read 10. It should be 10.
And if I just read 10. And if put on the new man, brother, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him.
Okay. Skip to 12, brother. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
It's all good. Put on, therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, bowels of mercy.
Bowels of mercy. I hope y'all be a lot of people, man, around the spot, man. Like, where's the mercy at, man? Where's the mercy at? Come on, keep going, brother.
Kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another, and forgiving one another.
Whew. Man, somebody need to put this up. You know what? I think I'm going to put it on a shirt and just put it on here and just walk around with that joint on, man. Look, forbearing one another, forgiving one another. Go ahead.
If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye.
You know what? Sometimes it just ain't that serious, y'all. In the greater scheme of things, it ain't that serious.
True.
Y'all got bigger fish to fry. We all do. We trying to make it into the kingdom. You know, you mean to tell me you want to keep yourself out the kingdom because
She just shouldn't have did that. She shouldn't have said that. Who she think she is? She got that on like that? She too big to have that on. You don't get out of the kingdom? Put yourself out of the kingdom just for silly stuff. You know what? She didn't say hi to me this morning. Maybe she didn't hear you. Did you bother to go back up to her and say make yourself known? Hi, sis. Hi, bro. Nah. They don't say hi to you. So you know what? I don't know who you think she is. You ain't even go up and try to quell that situation. Verse 10 says, and have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. You put on that new man, you're supposed to have bowels of mercy, humbleness, kindness, meekness, long-suffering. Come on, brother. Where you at?
14.
Go ahead.
And above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness.
What does charity cover?
Multitudes.
Y'all are well taught, man. Charity covers a multitude of sins, man. Above all these things, what things was he talking about? Above
mercies, kindness, humbleness of mind.
Come on.
Meekness, long suffering.
Go ahead. Keep reading.
Forbearing one another and forgiving one another.
Go ahead.
If any man have a quarrel against you, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye.
But above all doing that, what are you supposed to do?
Put on charity.
Which is the bond of perfectness. Skip down to, go to 18. And I'll put this in here because as we're doing all this, everybody got to submit to the Most High God. Everybody. Everybody has to do this. Come on, read, brother. Read.
Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands.
Come on.
As it is fit in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives, and be not bitter against them.
Mm-hmm.
Children, obey your parents in all things, for this is well-pleasing unto the Lord.
Go ahead.
Fathers, provoke not your children to anger, lest they be discouraged.
Go ahead.
Servants, obey in all things your masters according to the flesh. Not with eye service as men pleasers, but in singleness of heart, fearing God.
Why?
And whatsoever ye do, do it heartily as to the Lord and not unto men.
Is that what we do here? Do we do everything that we do, do we do it heartily as unto the Lord? That's something that you need to ask yourselves, brothers and sisters. Do you really? Would you, when it's time to, coming clean, I don't feel like doing that. Nah, I ain't gonna do that. When it's time to do service up in here, you know, clean up after your brothers and sisters. First and foremost, we should be cleaning up after ourselves. That's number one. That's number one. But for some reason in Israel, I think Israel just think they can just do whatever they want to do, and somebody gonna come up and clean up after them, whatever. But that's a whole other different story. But when it comes time to do your what you're supposed to do around here, the house of God, it makes me wonder, do you treat the house of God like you treat your house at home? Do you use the bathroom all over the seat, in the toilet seat at your house? Do you live filthy at your house? Because this house right here, it should be better than your own home. And although this is a poor excuse of what the house of God should be, because this is the Lord who created everything, but nonetheless, we do what we can here. This should be better off than where you even sitting at. Amen?
Amen.
Where you at, brother?
24
says what? Knowing that, did you read it already?
Nah.
No. Read 23 over again.
And whatsoever ye do, do it heartily as to the Lord and not unto men.
Go ahead.
Knowing that of the Lord ye shall receive the reward of inheritance, for ye serve the Lord Christ. But he that doeth wrong shall receive for the wrong which he hath done, and there is no respect of persons.
There is, Woo, knowing that of the Lord, you shall receive the reward of inheritance. For you serve the Lord. That's when anything you do at your job, you're supposed to do what you're supposed to do at your job. When you're at home, you do what you're supposed to do. When you're obeying your husband, you're doing what you're supposed to do. Husband, when you're obeying what the Lord said and not treating your wife, what? Bitterly. Not being bitter against your wife. See, far too often in the household, in the home, because I am a married man. Me and my wife have an argument or something to that effect, and she all too certain want to buck up against me. I said, listen, if you do that, you got your reward. You're going to get everything that you got coming to you. Whether it be me not saying nothing to you or me not, whatever, you're going to get everything that you got coming to you instead of letting the Lord do what he's supposed to do. Humility is supposed to come on always because the Lord is able to check me when he needs to. Amen? God has protocol. He has protocol how things go. We're not always happy, happy, joy, joy. We have arguments. We have fights. But guess what? You, if you're in the place where you need to be at, you can win me over strictly by your humility.
That's right.
And if I'm doing something wrong as being in front of the Lord, then the Lord would know how to check me. The Lord know how to check you. This is all important stuff, brothers and sisters, that we all should be reading because we have too much pride in the church. We have too much pride going on in here. We have no humility in here. And we're not trying to do what thus saith the Lord in here by the word. Where we at, brother?
That was it.
The Lord is no respecter of persons, brothers and sisters. If you're in your right place, when the judgments start coming down, you'll be fine. It don't matter who you are. We're going to go a little bit further. Go to Proverbs chapter 27. Proverbs 27, we'll read a couple verses here. Verse 2. We're going to skip. When you get there, brother, go ahead.
Let another man praise thee, and not thine own mouth. Mm-hmm. A stranger, and not thine own lips.
Skip down to verse 5.
Open rebuke is better than secret love. Faithful are the wounds of a friend, but the kisses of an enemy are deceitful.
I come here because this is how we should think, brothers and sisters. Let another man give you praise than praising yourself. This is going all part of this humility, being humble, not thinking yourself more than what you ought to think of yourself when you're nothing. Let another man praise thee, and not thine own mouth. Let a stranger, and not thine own lips. Open rebuke, brothers and sisters, is better than secret love. If you have an issue with your brother and sister here, they do something. Come and talk to them. Speak to them one-on-one. Speak to them like your brother and sister. Like you're saying, if you want somebody to treat you, do unto others as you would have them do unto you, then you would go to them and catch them. We of the household of faith are supposed to live this way towards one another. And don't take it some type of way. 9 times out of 10, you come to somebody and they take it and they feel some type of way about what you're saying, pride is in the mix. Because the mind frame of us should be, you know what, we're speaking to one another in love. Never to just condemn somebody. Our rebuke or our talking to one another is always because we're trying to better you. And it's not on some, I'm better than you. This is what we got to get out of the carnal thinking. It's not that I'm better than you. No, I see an error or a fault in my brother and sister that maybe they can be corrected upon. Holler at them. And then accept that. pray on it to the Lord. Help me to see the error of my ways too, Father. Help me to see, am I really treating it that way? Am I going to the Lord? Go to the Lord and ask him, am I really acting that way, Father? If I am, Father, forgive me. Help me to move on. Far too often, we are not really exercising what this word say. See, it's good to know this word. You know who else knows the word? Well, the devil. It's nothing to know the word. Who's justified before God? The doers of the word, aren't they? Are you doing it? I'm gonna take my time, brothers and sisters. Y'all got something to go? Y'all got some place to go? I'm gonna take my time. Because we need this. Where are we at, brother? Faithful are the wounds of a friend, but the kisses of an enemy are deceitful. Judas kissed the master before he betrayed him. But if you get wounded by a friend, it's all right. You know what? It hurt my pride a little bit, but guess what? I'm going to get up and move on because I know you love me. I know you meant well for me. I thought I was all that. I thought I was doing something good, but you know what? You checked me. Praise God that he sent you around me to check me. Far too often, people think that the Lord is just going to speak to him.
Ira, you're acting wrong. Do it right.
When Brother Stan just came and told me, listen, brother, you know what, man? You know what? You out there talking kind of crazy. I don't think you should do that. My wife came to me and said, hey, listen, husband, maybe you need to try to handle your affairs a little bit more better because we're in something. Now, the Lord just sent people right next to you and talk to you, but you're waiting for something miraculous to happen to you. God deals with men. He already said what he had to say in his word. He wrote it in the book for us to do, for us to read, and so that we can get it. Amen?
Amen.
Spend time in his word. You spending time in his word, or the lack thereof, shows how much. It just shows how much you are, or not. Read, brother. Oh, that was it?
Yeah.
Faithful are the wounds of a friend, but the kisses of an enemy are deceitful. Let's move on. Go to Timothy. Is it Timothy? John, sorry. John. Everybody wants heaven, but nobody wants dead, man. Nobody wants to die to themselves. Nobody wants to die to their lust. Nobody wants to die to their own passions that go against what God wants us to do. They don't want to die. They don't want to kill themselves. And you are commanded to die. John 13, I'm going to dig into this. John 13, verse 1, brother. When you get there, go ahead and read.
Now before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour was come, that he should depart out of this world unto the Father, having loved his own, which were in the world, he loved them unto the end. And supper being ended, the devil having now put into the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him, Jesus knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, mm-hmm. and that he was come from God and went to God, he riseth from supper and laid aside his garments and took a towel and girded himself.
Watch what the Lord does.
After that he poureth water into a basin, he began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel wherewith he was girded. Then cometh he to Simon Peter, and Peter saith unto him, Lord, dost thou wash my feet? Jesus answered and said unto him, What I do thou knowest not now, but thou shalt know hereafter. Peter saith unto him, Thou shalt never wash my feet. Jesus answered him, If I wash thee not, thou hast no part with me. Mm-hmm. Simon Peter saith unto him, Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head. Jesus saith to him, He that is washed needeth not save to wash his feet, but is clean every whit, mm-hmm. and ye are clean, but not all.
Okay, go ahead.
For he knew who should betray him, therefore he said, Ye are not all clean. So after he had washed their feet, he had taken his garments and was set down again and said unto them, Ye know what I have done to you? Ye call me master and Lord, and ye say, well, for so I am. If I then, your Lord and master, have washed your feet, ye also ought to wash one another's feet.
Yes. You gonna wash my feet? No. The custom back then, you know, because they wore sandals a lot. But this is very imperative. They wore a lot of sandals. You go in somebody in someone's home, you wash feet. They wash feet in there. It's a sign of humility and things of that nature. God was also letting you know that unless Jesus wash you, the spiritual indication, unless Jesus wash you, you're not clean. He had to come to do this for you. He had to come and wash us so that we'd be able to get into the kingdom. Because if he hadn't come and done this, then guess what? There'd be no reason for us to even be here. Wouldn't make it. So if Jesus can being God, be humble and wash our feet, why can't we do this? Why can't we do this with each other? Why can't we die to ourselves? Why can't we be humble? Why can't we cater to each other more? Where are we at, brother?
Verse 15.
Read it.
For I have given you an example that ye should do as I have done to you.
Mm-hmm.
Verily, verily, I say unto you, the servant is not greater than his Lord.
Come on.
Neither he that is sent greater than he that sent him.
So y'all not greater than Jesus? So y'all can be a little bit more loving and kind to each other around here. Y'all can spend more time with one another and spend more time in the word of God. Come on.
If ye know these things, happy are ye if ye do them. I speak not of you all.
Hold on, when are they happy?
If ye do them.
Maybe that's why a lot of people ain't happy up here. Maybe you're not doing what the Lord said to do. Maybe I can come up in here a little bit more often and see a little bit more smiles, a little bit more happiness, a little bit more joy. Because the Lord just told you something right here. Maybe it went over people's head, I don't know. But let me see, what is it? Read that part over again, brother. If what?
If ye know these things.
If you know what things?
The servant is not greater than his Lord.
Come on.
Neither is he. Neither he that is sent greater than he that sent him.
All right. And if you didn't know, what did you say?
If you know these things, mm-hmm. happy are ye if ye do them.
Go ahead.
I speak not of you all. I know whom I have chosen. But that the scripture may be fulfilled, he that eateth bread with me have lifted up his heel against me.
We know that scripture had to be fulfilled. We know that scripture had to be fulfilled. But in this statement right here, I'm going through it. This is a very powerful statement right here. The Lord knows whose is his. He knows who's his up in here right now. And in any house, in any great house, don't you have things that are honorable? Well, you know, let's read it. I don't want to get ahead of myself. The Lord knows who's his, right? I hope that you are. I hope that I am. Go to 2 Timothy 2 and 19. Jesus got down and washed his betrayer's foot. And he knew it. He knew it. Come on. 2 Timothy 2 and 19. A couple verses here. He knew it. Brothers and sisters, this may be dry, but I hope you paid attention to it. Go home and read this stuff. Read this word. This is very serious. We don't have the luxury of always knowing who is good for us and who ain't good for us. Some people talk right in your face and be hating you, right to your face. But Jesus, he knew who was good for him. He knew who was for him and who he wasn't. But he's our example. Always. If you're a Christian, that means you're Christ-like. You do what Christ says to do. And if he washed his betrayer's foot, can you wash or could you be nice to a person that's cussing you out? Or could you give them some food that really don't think well of you? Could you? Could you pray for that person? Like the Lord says to do? All right, come on, brother. Let's get it. You there?
Yes, sir.
Read, brother.
Nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure.
It is? Go ahead.
Having this seal, the Lord knoweth them that are his.
Mm-hmm.
And let every one that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity.
Please.
But in a great house there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth,
mm-hmm.
and some to honor and some to dishonor. If a man therefore purge himself from these, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified and meet for the master's use, and prepared unto every good work.
All right. You purge yourself from what? Fornication, uncleanness, evil concupiscence, evil desires, lying to one another. You purge yourself of these things and you'll be a vessel unto honor. Nobody, look, in a great house, Israel is a great house, right or wrong? Great house. But guess what? You could be a vessel under dishonor in this great house if you don't purge yourself of all these things that's going to get that, all these iniquities or any kind of sin that's going to lead you out of the way of keeping God's commandment. You would be a vessel for dishonor. Go a little bit further. Go to Romans 12. Romans 12, 1-21, brother. Romans 12, 1-21. When you get there, brother, go ahead and read.
I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service.
Reasonable. It's reasonable service. Guy came, got mocked, killed, spit upon, scourged. Didn't have to, but for you. In your sinful state. He did this for you. It's just only a reasonable service to present your body as a living sacrifice to him. The things that you, my wants, my needs, my so-called needs, my wants. Let me get them up for the kingdom. And that's a reasonable service. Go ahead, brother.
And be not conformed to this world.
Be not conformed to this world. Go ahead.
But be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind.
How do you renew your mind, brothers and sisters? You're just going to sit down one day and think, watching Cake Boss or watching Housewives of Atlanta is going to renew your mind? No, you renew your mind by staying in that word. That's how you renew your mind. That's how you're going to get your thoughts on par with the Father's thoughts. Because unless your mind is like Christ Jesus, you ain't going to make it. You are not going to make it. Everybody should be examining themselves. Examine yourselves. Will you think you all that? Or, examine yourselves. Make sure it lines up with this word. You know, I got a little homework assignment for everybody. You know what I mean? And you can care to tell me when we meet back up here, Lord willing, next Sabbath. How much time did you spend reading this week? Mark it on your calendar. Mark it on your refrigerator, in your bathroom when you get ready to use the bathroom. You know what? I need to tell Brother Ira how much time I spent reading when I see him next Sabbath, Lord willing, because we don't know when our day is. Let's see how much time you take. You know what I mean? You really don't have to tell me, but I mean, I just want y'all to do that for yourselves. where are we at, brother?
Middle of two.
Go ahead, brother.
That ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
How are you going to prove what is the acceptable and perfect will of God unless you read God's word? Go ahead.
For I say, through the grace given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly, according as God hath dealt to every man the measure of faith.
Okay. Keep on reading, brother.
For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office, so we, being many, are one body in Christ, and every one members of another. Having then gifts differing according to the grace that is given to us, whether prophecy, let us prophesy according to the proportion of faith, or ministry, let us wait on our ministering, or he that teacheth on teaching.
Listen, y'all ever have people, you have our brothers and sisters that's in here that are real special at doing what they do. You know what, Sister Tamika, she can draw a lot. She draws real well. My brother right here, Kareem, you do your rapping, right? My brother Arthur, he's very, very knowledgeable in the word of God. You know what we can do in this? You know, cultivate, help each other in what they do. We're all a many-membered body. All should be of one mind. Talk with one another. Help build each other up so that we can go out here in this world and be more prepared for when we go out here amongst this onslaught of idolatry and all type of madness that's out here in this world. You come here, instead of daggone talking about whatever else, you know what? Get into this word with one another. Help sharpen up each other in this word. And don't think just because somebody may be nice in the word or whatever, you know what I mean? Don't get envious of them. Don't get jealous of them. No, because you have your own position. That's far too often. That's what Israel do. They see somebody thinking that, you know what? He spoke real well. She spoke real well. Now you want to get all, you know what? Now envy will creep in. Jealousy will creep in. Then as soon as the person says something that you don't like, who does he think he is? Quick, this is what we do to each other. What does the Bible say right here? For as we, verse 4 says, for as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office. We all don't have the same office. So stop looking at other people like, you know, I can be like him. Be like you. So we being many are one in Christ, and everyone members one of another. I call my brother, look, I'm out here prophesying and teaching on the corner. Hey, I don't have a question. I'll call a brother Arthur real quick. No, I ain't got that. Hold on. Yo, Art, what's this? Where I find this at? Oh, yeah, thank you, brother. You know what I'm saying? You're helping build the kingdom up this way. When you're not consumed on what somebody else is doing, but you're using it. Because we're all one body, brothers and sisters. How are we going to look to the so-called super brews out there and the people that's in the church if we can't even get it together up in here? We say we got the truth. We can't even get it together up here. Where are you at, brother?
Verse 8,
what does it say?
Or he that exhorteth on exhortation, he that giveth, let him do it with simplicity.
There's people out here that give. You say, let them give with simplicity. Maybe you have a lot to give, but how you going to give something? If somebody give me something, I'll tell you like this. Don't be giving it to me all out in front of people so you can shine and whatnot. You know what? You come to my brother, you know what I'm saying? See people around you. There's just ways to do it. I love you, brother. You know what I'm saying? Word. All right, how you feeling? How's everybody? Good. Give them something. Drop it off. Don't be like the hypocrite, dude. Yeah, how you feeling, brother? You know what I'm saying? See? You know what I mean? Yeah. It's good. You know? Oh, how much you need, brother? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Hold on. Nah, it's good. It's all good. I got it. Got you. There you go, brother. You know, get that back to me whenever you can, brother. For real? The Bible said, what? Give with what? Simplicity? What does it say, brother? Read that again. Read that right there. Read it again.
Or he that exhorteth or an exhortation, he that giveth, let him do it with simplicity.
With simplicity. What? He that ruleth, rule with diligence. You can't be up here on giving this word of God out and be wishy-washy at home. The Lord will confound you. That's why it's a very serious thing. I don't take it lightly. Being up here, it's a serious, serious thing to be up here. Go ahead.
He that showeth mercy with cheerfulness.
He that showeth mercy, do it with cheerfulness. Listen, sister, brother. Yeah, well, you know what? Yeah, you did come off wrong, but you know what? It's all right. Yeah, you said something real crazy to me last week, but you know what? It's all right, sweet. Sorry, bro. It's all right. Not for real. It's okay. I'm not being silly with it, but I'm serious. It's okay. You're esteeming somebody else now. You're looking out for their feelings, although your feeling was hurt. You don't want nobody to have mercy on you, but then have mercy like this. You know what? Yeah, it's good. Don't do it again. You got my mercy. Nah, be easy. It's all right, brother and sister. It's okay. Y'all understand where I'm coming from with this? Do you understand,
True.
A little bit? Huh?
No doubt.
All right. Where are we at, brother?
9.
Verse 9.
Let love be without dissimulation.
Mm-hmm.
Abhor that which is evil.
Abhor that which is evil. Hate it. Go ahead.
Cleave to that which is good.
What are we supposed to be to each other? Verse 10.
Be kindly affectioned one to another with brotherly love, in honor, preferring one another.
Look at that. Do we do that? When somebody, when they say something crazy to you, do you prefer, you know what? Are you quick to let your feelings be known to somebody else? That you're upset about what they're talking about? Or are you reserved? Be kindly affectioned one to another with brotherly love, in honor, preferring one another. Go ahead.
Not slothful in business.
Go ahead.
Fervent in spirit.
Go ahead.
Serving the Lord.
Go ahead.
Rejoicing in hope. Patient in tribulation.
We need this. He says rejoicing in hope. Go ahead.
Continuing instant in prayer.
Continuing instant in prayer. This is what you're supposed to be doing all the time. Not slothful in business, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord, rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, because that's what we're going to. Continuing instant in prayer. Go ahead.
Distributing to the necessity of saints, given to hospitality.
Come on, brother.
Keep bless reading. Them which persecute you, bless and curse not. Rejoice with them that do rejoice, and weep with them that weep. Be of the same mind one toward another. Mind not high things, but condescend to men of low estate.
Mm-hmm.
Be not wise in your own conceits.
Now, this is what we're hard to do. Verse 17.
Recompense to no man evil for evil. Provide things honest in the sight of all men.
And what else?
If it be possible, as much as lieth in you, live peaceably with all men.
Yeah, and I'm glad that that was put up in there, because some people you just ain't going to. Lord, I try. I try, Lord. Just keep me away from him, Lord. I'm going to buck him down. You know what I mean? If possible. Just the mind you're supposed to be up in there. Go ahead.
Dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves.
Who does vengeance belong to? Come on.
But rather give place unto wrath. For it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, saith the Lord.
And now it's seeming like we have to have a whole bunch of mercy, a whole bunch of patience, a whole bunch of long suffering for the kingdom's sake, for the Lord's sake. But are we operating in that? Everybody want to go to heaven. Nobody want dead. You don't want to die to yourself. You don't want to, no matter what, look for the way that you can be humble in every situation. Look how you can be humble in every situation that you do. We done there?
No.
Keep reading.
Therefore, if thine enemy hunger, feed him. If he thirst, give him drink.
If your enemy hunger, feed him or her. Can y'all do that? Come on.
If he thirsts, give him drink.
Your enemy. Your enemy. Keep on going, brother.
For in so doing.
What's going to happen?
Thou shalt heap coals of fire on his head.
Do y'all understand that? That scripture right there? How would you be heaping coals of hot fire on your enemy's head by giving them what he needs? How? You understand that you are the apple of God's eye when you're doing what you're supposed to do, right? Lord says, touch not my anointed, right? You're not supposed to. By feeding your enemy, and if they don't repent and they still want to keep doing you wrong, who do you think is going to come after that guy? The Lord is going to send wrath after that dude. Or it's going to, and matter of fact, it might be so bad that you might have to pray for him. Lord, please, Lord, have mercy on that man. Have mercy on him. It might be just that bad, because God knows how to get people 1,000 times more than you can ever do. What happened with Job's friend? When Job's friend was talking all out the way and out of pocket, what did the Lord say to Job? He said, listen, pray for your friends. No, he told them that he going to have his servant Job pray for him. Let's see, deal with him after they follow. You understand? There's power in this. If we work it the way it's supposed to be worked, brothers and sisters, there's power in this word. And we got to keep on doing it. We have to do it. You have to. Otherwise, bind him hand and foot. Where we at, brother?
21.
Read it.
Be not overcome of evil, but overcome evil with good.
That's how we're supposed to be. We move a little further. Go ahead, brother. Where we at?
Romans 5.
Romans chapter 5, brother. A few more, we almost done. Just back a couple pages. Romans chapter 5. One through eight. When you get there, go ahead and read, brother.
Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Faith without works is what, brothers and sisters? So you got to work. You got to do something, right? Go ahead.
By whom also we have access by faith into this grace wherein we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God.
Go ahead.
And not only so, but we glory in tribulations also.
We supposed to. Go ahead.
Knowing that tribulation worketh patience.
Yeah, the greater thing. Y'all want to be patient? Y'all want to be patient out there? Then you have to go through some. You got to go through something to get patience. Go ahead.
And patience, experience, and experience, hope.
There it is. So now, when you have that tribulation, and it starts coming around again, because Lord does things in cycles. They come around again to see how you're going to act. You don't you know that your trials and your tribulations are all a test unto you? They're all a test unto you. Your whole life is a test to see if you're able to make it. You know what? You think you aced that drinking? You think you aced that smoking too much? You think you aced somebody coming and talking to you kind of crazy? You know, I know how to deal with that. I know how to deal with somebody coming and talking to me crazy. You know what? Lord gonna send it around to you. Let me make sure she's straight. Yeah, you think you got it? Because everybody's supposed to take heed unless he fall. Anybody that think that you got this together, right? You're supposed to take heed unless you fall. You're always supposed to be on your guns. As long as you're living, you're supposed to be always having your head on swivel, just in case. Because what does the adversary do? The adversary, the devil, like a roaring lion, is doing what? Seeking whom he may devour, right? Walking up and down the earth, seeking whom he may devour. See if you're weak. You're always going to be tested until the Lord come back or you go to the grave. You test it. Because you can get right to the end and blow the mission. So don't ever get comfortable. If you're getting comfortable, you comfortable in this thing, you know what? You're wrong then. Hold it in, brother. Hold it. Where we at?
Verse 5.
Read it.
And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us.
Come on now.
For when we were yet without strength,
what happened?
In due time Christ died for the ungodly.
Praise the Lord.
For scarcely for a righteous man will one die, yet peradventure for a good man some would even dare to die.
Go ahead.
But God commendeth his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
I asked earlier, would y'all die for me? Sister D said, nah. But listen, it's right here. For scarcely for a righteous man will one die. Yet perhaps or peradventure for a good man, some would even dare to die. But God commended his love to us, word, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. We ought to die for our brothers and sisters. Die to ourselves. Die to our passions. Die to our lust. Die to our wants. Die to what we want to do. Die to our selfishness. That's how we're supposed to be, brothers and sisters. Go ahead.
That was it, bro.
Well, we're going to go a little further. Go to Mark. Jesus is our great example. Mark 8 and 31. Mark 8 and 31. And when you get there, brother, go ahead.
And he began to teach them that the Son of Man must suffer many things and be rejected of the elders and of the chief priests and scribes and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. And he spake that saying openly, and Peter took him and began to rebuke him.
Well, you know, we all know this story, don't we? You know, we know this. Not so, Lord. He is real zealous for the Lord. You know, not so. Don't say it. But the thing is, he's telling them about what's going to happen to him. Again, the Lord knew what was going to happen to him. And he still died for us. He still did what was required of him to do. We being Christians, we're supposed to do what's required of us to do. To die. You know it now. You know you got to die. You know you got to die to them selfish deeds. You know you got to die to them wants and things that you think is right. Stay in the word and the Lord will show you what is right. He's always showing you what's right. He's always. But are you in the word enough so that you can be humble enough to do what God is requiring you to do? You got to stay in this word. And it displays itself, brothers and sisters, how much you are in the word or not in the word. Believe me. So go ahead, brother. What do you say? He's showing them now. He's saying at verse 31, and he began to teach them that the Son of Man must suffer many things and to be rejected of the elders, of the chief priests and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. And he spake that saying openly, and Peter took him and began to rebuke. I'm sorry, go ahead, finish reading, brother.
I read that, 33.
Go ahead.
But when he had turned about and looked on his disciples, he rebuked Peter, saying, get thee behind me, Satan, for thou savorest not the things that be of God, but the things that be of men.
Now see, that's what should happen with people. It's not the people that you upset with. It may be the spirit behind the people that we're dealing with, brothers and sisters. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, brothers and sisters. And we got to be mindful of this thing. You got to be mindful when you want to sit here and start talking to your brother and sister all sideways, looking at them sideways, thinking things in your heart sideways about your brothers and sisters, and instead of correcting it right then and there, instead of harboring some ill intent for weeks on end, letting the devil, giving the foothold to the devil so he can come in and start thinking all type of stuff about your brothers and sisters. Now, before you know it, there's division in the church when it could have been settled right then and there. The Lord shows you how to do this thing. Go ahead, brother.
34. And when he had called the people unto him with his disciples also, he said unto them, Whosoever will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it, but whosoever shall lose his life for my sake and the gospel's, the same shall save it. For what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul?
Go ahead.
Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? Whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed, when he cometh in the glory of his Father with the holy angels.
We got work to do, brothers and sisters. We got work to do. You can display your shame for the Lord by your actions. You ain't got to say it. You ain't got to say it. In this sinful, what did you say? Whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him will I also, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he cometh in his glory, in the glory of his Father with his holy angels. And you don't want that. You got to die. Whole week, man, a whole week. You know, you shouldn't be waiting all week just to get the Sabbath, to get in this word. Brothers, take time to build lessons. They got lessons on the YouTube and everything. You know what? Turn your TV off. You're going to have your TV on. Watch them lessons. Read your book. Ask the Lord. You know, maybe some of y'all, it's not a requirement, but maybe some of y'all got to fast during the week. Get serious with the Lord, because I don't know if y'all looking out here, time is getting, is winding up. It's moving real fast. It's starting to move real fast. And I have to tell you, you know, the Lord says, if that servant starts to be drunken and start to revel and start doing all these things, the Lord is going to come up on you without you even knowing it. Come up on you like a thief. Be sure that everything that you do is done as unto the Lord, brothers and sisters. Because this is serious here. And you don't want the Lord to be ashamed of you. You want the Lord to come and say to you, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Enter into the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the earth. That's what you want the Lord to say to you. Keep reading, brother.
That was all, bro.
All right, we're going to go a little further. Go to Philippians. Go to Philippians. Philippians chapter 2, verse 14. When you get there, brother, Philippians 2, verse 14.
Do all things without murmurings and disputings, that ye may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God, without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom ye shine as lights in the world, holding forth the word of life, that I may rejoice in the day of Christ, that I have not run in vain, neither labored in vain.
Do all things, brothers and sisters, without murmuring or disputing. Pay attention. I ask people. You know it is what it is. I ask people to clean in here. Straight up. I ask people to do some cleaning up in here. You know? People don't, you know, when I ask a couple of people. You know, I don't even clean my house. You want me to clean up in here? Do all things without murmuring or disputing. Hey, we're gonna change our how we gonna do our feast. We're gonna do it this way. D Do all things without murmuring or disputing. That ye may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God, without rebuke in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom you shine as lights. If we can't be obedient in this house, how do you expect to change anybody that's out in the street? How do you expect to change? Where we at, brother?
25.
Read it.
Yet I supposed it necessary to send to you Epaphroditus, my brother and companion in labor and fellow soldier, but your messenger and he that ministered to my wants.
Now see, I want to read you an example of somebody that is so serious about his business, about the service of God. He didn't let his physical or his wants overcome what he was supposed to do for the Father. Read it, brother. Read verse 25 again.
Yet I supposed it necessary to send to you Epaphroditus, my brother and companion in labor, mm-hmm. and fellow soldier, but your messenger and he that ministered to my wants.
Mm-hmm.
For he longed after you and was full of heaviness because that ye had heard that he had been sick.
All right, yeah, now he's talking to the Philippians. They heard that this man had been sick, but go ahead.
For indeed he was sick nigh unto death.
Go ahead.
But God had mercy on him, and not on him only, but on me also, lest I should have sorrow upon sorrow.
Okay, go ahead. I'll go skip to verse 30.
Because for the work of Christ, he was nigh unto death.
Because what?
For the work of Christ, he was nigh unto death.
Go ahead.
Not regarding his life, to supply your lack of service toward me.
You understand this? How many of us can say that? I mean, how many of us can even scratch the surface of that? This man was so in the dawn and performing the work of God in the ministry that his life was in peril because of this. Unto death. Nigh unto death. Because of the service that he was doing for the Father. Can you say that? I just want to show you that it's real up in here. Skip back to verse 5, brother, and read.
Let this mind be in you, which also was in Christ Jesus.
Couldn't come here without saying this. Read it, brother.
Who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God.
Go ahead.
But made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross.
Can we do that? Can we do that? Can you humble yourself? Come obedient to this word? Become obedient to the Lord? Kill yourself. Daily. Can you do that? Let's see what you're going to do this whole week. Let's see what you do this week. Let's see how much you get into this word this week. Let's see how much you're on your knees before the Lord. Somebody needs to be on our face before the Lord, man. Because it's not a game, man. We out here dying and you living comfy and cool in your pristine house. And you'll ride past your brother and sister. Won't even stop. You stop somebody if they got a flat on the side of the road. You got AAA and you won't even offer nothing. You won't even offer your AAA because why? You don't know them? Somebody got to do something for you in order for you to do something for somebody else, huh? That's what it is. I don't know, man. A lot of people be putting me to shame. My brother Brandon, since I've known that brother, them had people come and stay in his home. He done offered his home to a whole bunch of people. I met him, and he done given me a few things, a slew of things, and helped me with my car and did a whole bunch of things, didn't ask me for nothing. My brother Tyler over here, yes, we have Gentiles in the building, so when y'all hearing this, you know what I mean? My brother Tyler came over here. Don't know him from a can of paint because he knew me, and he came, and he's of the word. Let this brother stay right in his house. How many people would do that, man? Stranger. Straight up stranger. and you call yourselves Christians. You call yourselves following the Most High God. Sure, you okay? Shame on us, man. Shame on us. Let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus, who being the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation and put upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself. You finished reading that?
Yeah.
And became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Y'all know the story? Y'all know the story? When Christ went to go pray in Gethsemane, he wanted that cup to pass from him, right? He all right? Is he all right? Where you at, brother?
Galatians 6.
Finish reading.
It's the new one. It's the next one.
All right, go ahead, brother. Go to Galatians 6. Galatians 6. Galatians 6, brothers and sisters. Galatians 6, brothers and sisters. And when you get there, brother, go ahead and start reading.
Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such an one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bear ye one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ.
Mm-hmm. What's that law? Love your brother as yourself. Love your neighbor as yourself. Go ahead.
For if a man think himself to be something when he is nothing, he deceiveth himself.
All right, go ahead.
But let every man prove his own work, and then shall he have rejoicing in himself alone and not in another.
Mm-hmm.
For every man shall bear his own burden.
Which is the truth. We shall. Go ahead.
Let him that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth in all good things. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap.
Understand that, brothers and sisters. You want to be happy? Do you sow mercy? You're going to receive mercy. You sow, if you're happy and you're friendly, you're going to get friendliness. All right? If you sow hate, you're going to receive hate. This is universal law right here. Go ahead, brother.
For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting.
Mm-hmm.
And let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not.
There it is. And that's what it is. Don't think just that you're giving and doing things, it don't seem like you're going to get a payoff on it. No, if you're always giving, understand this, that you have to give. So if you're always giving, you know, your kindness, if you're always giving doesn't always have to be necessarily a materialistic thing. Again, you know, you're always giving a good word to somebody. You're always giving a smile to somebody. You're always telling somebody, you know, it's going to be okay, brother or sister. You're going to make it through. Keep on persevering. You're always being there. Guess what? In due season, if you don't faint, you're going to reap. Verse 9 says, and let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Go ahead, brother. Verse 10.
As we have, therefore, opportunity, let us do good unto all men, especially unto them who are of the household of faith.
Let us do good to some men.
All men.
only those that do the will of the Father.
Oh.
Okay. Especially those who are of the household of faith. This is what we're supposed to do. This is what we're called to do, brothers and sisters. First, Hebrews chapter 12. We've got a couple more. This is our life. This is what we should be doing. Hebrews chapter 12, 1 through 6. We'll do some skipping around. Hebrews 12, 1 through 6. And when you get there, brother, go ahead and read.
Wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us.
Read that again, brother, so read it nice and loud so they can hear that.
Wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth so easily beset us.
Pay attention to that, brothers and sisters. Y'all should, somebody should highlight that one right there. Highlight it for yourself. Go ahead, brother.
And let us run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. For consider him that endures such contradiction of sinners against himself, lest ye be wearied and faint in your mind.
Now he's giving you instruction here, Brother Paul is, you know what I mean? For consider him that endures such contradictions of sinners against himself. Consider that when you're getting mocked, when you're getting laughed at, consider your Savior. Consider what happened to him. You know what I mean? Who was perfect in every way, didn't deserve to die. So now you can go on and be a little bit strengthened, be more strengthened so that you can endure your mocking and your scourging, your laughing at. Go ahead, brother.
Ye have not yet resisted unto blood, striving against sin.
And you haven't. None of us have yet. Ain't nobody, did anybody slap you upside your head for you telling them that, you know what, going to Sunday church is a sin? Ain't nobody slap you upside your head yet for telling them, listen, man, you need to stop eating pork. That ain't happened yet. Yet. Listen, it is an abomination for man to sleep with man. Did somebody come and bust you upside your head yet? No. We ain't resisted unto blood yet, brothers and sisters. But it's going to happen. I'm here to let you know it's going to happen. It's coming up. Fast approaching. I hope you're ready. Go ahead, brother.
5. And ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you as unto children.
What did he say?
My son, despise not thou the chastening of the Lord, nor faint when thou art rebuked of him.
Go ahead.
For whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth, and scourgeth every son whom he receiveth.
All right, understand that. So, you know, if you're feeling some type of way a little bit when brothers get up here or you hear something that's not favorable in your life, understand the chastening of the Lord. Get it together. Because whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth. And guess what? When you have this in your mind that, listen, I don't have it all together, when you start thinking that on yourself, it's more easy to understand, you know what I mean, that I need work. You need work. We all need work here. I don't have it all together. I'm trying to tell you something, brothers and sisters. I don't have it all together. Matter of fact, sometimes I hang my head down because I'm like, man, you know you need to be doing better than this, Ira. It's not comfortable, man, living for the Lord, but it gets easier. It gets easier. You got to make sure, man, I'm making sure I'm talking right out here in the street. I'm making sure I'm thinking right. Because just because you won't say it out loud don't mean these angels ain't writing it down. Watching what I look at, man. Because I know me. I have a very vivid mind. Wake up out of my sleep like, no, Lord, please. Serious. What am I thinking about here, man? You need to stay in this word a little bit more often. Get right. I big up my brother Arthur right, Fab, because he told me something. He told me, let another man esteem you, brother. Let another man esteem you. I already know how he's going to say. But see, we admire. Look. I admonish the brother because he's very quick on the word. Quick. But guess what the brother told me, and I'm going to use you right now, brother. He said, listen, man, I was slipping. And I had to fast for, I forgot how long he said he had to fast for, because the Lord started stripping him. Stripping him of that good, clean, sharp knowledge because of something that he did. Now, you know. And he had to humble himself. Get back right. Let me cut off this food for myself. Let me cut off this playing around for myself so I can get back where I need to be at. And everybody know, you all know what you are capable of. You know what's good for you. And that's my little spot on Brother Arthur right quick. I'm get off you, brother. But listen, the Lord will take it from you. He'll take it from you. You think this is a game. You keep on thinking that this is a game, and you think you're standing, and you think you know what time it is. And when somebody come up here and tell you something about, hey, brother, sister, you need to do this, you think you got it all together. The Lord will strip what you have and give it to somebody else. And you be around here walking around in confusion, and then you be walking around in confusion your whole time you're here, and then guess what? Sky crack, and you wondering why you ain't. I thought I did this right. It's real talk, man. This is real talk. You think this is a game, man? You ain't did what you had to do. Y'all stupid, too. I just want to let y'all know that. All right, here we go. Where we at?
14.
Read, brother.
Follow peace with all men.
Follow peace with all men. Go ahead.
And holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord.
You hear that? Follow peace with all men and holiness. What makes you holy? I'm asking. What makes you holy?
The word.
Oh, okay. The word makes you holy. Just the word makes you holy? I got the word right here. That made me holy? Oh, okay. Okay. All right. For without what?
Without which no man shall see the Lord.
All right, so you better do this word. Follow me as I follow Christ, brothers and sisters. If I'm doing something crazy, you know what? Hey, don't follow me. But let me tell you something. Follow me as I follow Christ, brothers and sisters. Get on your knees. Turn that TV off. If you got children, teach your children. And you teaching your children, you got to learn, because you ain't going to teach your child nothing crazy, are you? That means you got to be up in it. Amen. Ray!
Looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you, and thereby many be defiled.
Looking diligently. When you do something diligently, that's attentively. Do it tenderly. Lest any man fail the grace of God. You can fail the grace of God, brothers and sisters?
That's what it said.
You can fail that? I need to tell some of these people out here in the Sunday churches. I'm under grace. You can fail the grace of God, brother. Where is that at? Hebrews chapter 12, verse 15. Look at it, brother. Sister. Lest any root of bitterness spring up in you, and thereby many be defiled. Is that it?
That's it, bro.
That is it. Go a little bit further. Come on, go to Ephesians. I'm tripping. Ephesians chapter 4, we'll start at verse 21, brother. When you get there, brother, go ahead and read.
If so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him as the truth is in Jesus, that ye put off concerning the former conversation the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lusts, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness.
It is created in what? Righteousness and true holiness, right? How do you renew your mind, brothers and sisters? How do you renew your mind, brothers and sisters?
Word of God.
We don't know. Nobody knows. I'm sorry. No. You're the only one that know how you renew your mind? I know Brother Arthur know. By the washing.
The word.
The word renews your mind, brothers and sisters. The word. So if you don't have the word in you, then obviously you had that old mind in you. It's real simple with God. It's real simple. 22 says that ye put off concerning the former conversation of the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust. And remember, when you got into that water, you said you ain't going to be that man no more. And renew and be renewed in the spirit of your mind. Go ahead, brother.
Wherefore, 25.
Wherefore,
putting away lying.
Go ahead.
Speak every man truth with his neighbor.
Go ahead.
For we are all members one of another.
Go ahead.
Be ye angry and sin not.
Now, here it is. Be ye angry. Sin not. Read on, brother.
Let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. Let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands the thing which is good, that he may have to give to him that needeth.
Go ahead.
Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers.
Amen. Go ahead.
And grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby ye are sealed unto the day of redemption.
You can grieve the Holy Spirit, yeah?
That's what it say.
Go ahead.
Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. All
right.
And be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you.
Well, you know, I'm under grace right now. Jesus did it all. It looked like you can do some things too, right? I'm under grace, but I can be bitter towards my brother and sister. I can have malice in my heart, which is deceit and mischief in my heart towards my brother and sister. I can put a Christmas tree up in my house. I'm under grace. God understands. I'm doing it because it's his birthday. He wasn't born on December 25th. Well, he was born. I'm under grace. Bind them hand and foot. All right, brother, let's go a little bit further. We got one more and we'll be out of here. You got to put away all this stuff, brothers and sisters. Come on. James chapter 4, verse 7, 8 and 10. And we should be done there. Read, brother.
Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Be afflicted and mourn, and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning, and your joy to heaviness. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-mm-mm. Read that all over again, brother. Read it again. Verse 7 and 8. Read through all the way through 10. All
right. Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you.
Mm-hmm.
Draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh to you. Yes, cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, ye double-minded.
Draw nigh. This is, submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, brothers and sisters, and he shall flee from you. Draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh to you. Cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, ye double-minded. A double-minded man is unstable in what?
All his ways.
So that means you have to come and become singleness of heart again, brothers and sisters. Fall in love with your first love again. Do what you're supposed to do with the Father. Be afflicted. Go ahead.
And mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning and your joy to heaviness. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up.
There it is, brothers. And that's everybody wants heaven, nobody wants dead. Hope somebody got some understanding in Jesus' name. We have our Sabbath day announcements.
We welcome you and hope today's lesson increased your knowledge of the Holy Bible. Audio and videotapes, CDs, and DVDs of the Sabbath lessons and of Thy Kingdom Come are available. Write your order on an offering envelope and it will be filled next Sabbath. If you are interested in being baptized, please place your name on the list at the literature table. Remember to follow the dress code when attending our services. Men should remove hats and all head coverings during service times. Women should wear a head covering, such as a hat or scarf, during the service. Women should not wear tight-fitting pants or skirts or revealing clothing. Attire should be modest according to the Bible. Your tithes and offerings are always appreciated. Please place your tithes and offerings in an envelope and deposit it in the offering box. If your child becomes restless during the Bible lesson, we encourage you to remove your child from the room until he or she has settled. Your cooperation is greatly appreciated. Again, thank you for coming, and we hope to see you on the next Sabbath. Peace.
Peace, peace. All right, I don't think we have anything else. Yes, sir. Monthly fast. Yes, yes. The 28th. Monday? Okay. Monthly fast, you know, you usually do that on the new moon. 28th, sundown, the sundown, I do it one day.
I hope everybody participates. Take heed, brothers and sisters. Time is getting short. Draw nigh to your Father.
All right, if that's it, we'll stand and face Jerusalem and close out.
Our Father, which art in heaven.
Our Father, which art in heaven.
Hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done in earth.
Thy will be done in earth.
As it is in heaven.
As it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
This day our daily bread.
And forgive us our debts.
And forgive us our debts.
As we forgive our debtors.
As we forgive our debtors.
And lead us not into temptation.
And lead us not into temptation.
But deliver us from evil.
But deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom.
For thine is the kingdom.
And the power.
And the power.
And the glory forever.
And the glory forever.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
For he is good.
For he is good.
For his mercy endureth forever.
For his mercy endureth forever.
Praise the Lord God of Israel.
Praise the Lord God of Israel.
For he is good.
For he is good.
For his mercy endureth forever.
For his mercy endureth forever.
In Jesus' name. We pray.
In Jesus' name we pray.
The Lamb of God.
The Lamb of God.
The Lion of Judah.
The Lion of Judah.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
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 In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.